Dear student, I am Hare Ram Singh, assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science. For this semester, I will be taking System Software and Compilers, subject code 18CA61 for you people. So, it's a very interesting subject. So, in this this is my first lecture video for this subject. So in this video, I am going to discuss the introduction about the system software and compilers and system software and application software. We will also find out the differences between system software and application software. So let us go ahead. So first of all, we would like to give the definition of the system software. What is the system software? So system software, it is a set of programs to perform a variety of system functions as file editing, resource management, input-output management and storage management. So actually it is a set of program which manages the hardwares along with file editing, resource management, input-output management and storage management. So like for example, we can see that operating system, it is one kind of system software which is responsible for the editing of the file, resource management, input-output management and storage management. Another definition of the system software is system program are intended to support the operation and use of computer itself rather than any particular application. So here it is a set of program which support the operation of computers and it makes the computer to work smoothly. For this reason, they are usually related to the architecture of the machine on which they are run. So, because of this reason only, system software is hardware concerned, hardware oriented. So, if that hardware, if in the computer we have a 32-bit processor, then operating system should also be a 32-bit, or system software will be 32-bit. If it is 64-bit processor, then it will be, operating system should also be a 64-bit. So it is hardware or architecture oriented. System softwares are platform oriented. For example, the different kind of system softwares are operating system, utility programs, compilers, assemblers, linkers, loaders, text editors and all those things. Next one, it is application software. So application software, it is also a program, but it is primarily concerned with the solution of some problem. It is concerned with only one problem, a specific problem, using the computer as a tool, and it use computer as a tool to solve that problem. So for example, Excel is there. So Excel only one specific work we do. We enter the data, edit the data. Word is there. Word is also an application program. PowerPoint is there. It is also an application program. One specific problem will be doing. Or any different mobile app we develop, or desktop application we develop. So these things comes under the application software. Next, the different kinds of the system softwares are text editor. It is there to create and modify the program. It is the text editor where we write the data, we enter the data. Then compiler and assembler. So it translates the programs into machine language. So compiler converts the high level language into the assembly language, and assembler converts the assembly language into the object code or object program. Then loader or linker. So the resulting machine program was loaded into memory and prepared for execution. Loader and linker will load the machine program into the memory where the processor will execute those programs. Then debugger. It is there to help detect errors in the program. Debugger will help us to detect the errors in the program. Let us see using the diagram how things are connected in the machine. So down that lower part of the machine, it is a bare machine. It is a hardware. It's a hardware computer device. So inside the hardware, the operating system, which is called the system software, will be loaded. Now operating system will be responsible for memory management, process management, device management, and information management. After that, we have another system software, debugger, compiler, assembler, load and linker, microprocessor, text editor, utility program. So all these things are called system software. After that, application programs will be loaded, like text editor, PowerPoint, Excel, mobile application, desktop application, and all those things. And after that, users will be there. So users will develop the application program using these system softwares in the computer. The differences between the system software and application software is, the system software, it is a set of programs that help to run computer system. So system software, it is a set of program which makes the computer to work. But application software, it is used by user to solve the problem using computer as a tool. So using the computer as a tool, user can develop the application software. It is next difference is system software. It is a machine oriented software. So for 32-bit operating system should be 32-bit. For 64-bit system software should be 64-bit. But application software is not a machine oriented. Same point, it is a machine dependent. Application software is not machine independent. It's not machine dependent. It is machine independent. Then system software, it directly interacts with the hardware. And application software, it does not directly interact with the hardware. Then again, in the system software, development of software is a complex task. It is a very huge number of lines of programs will be written for the system of software. But compared to that, application software is much more easier and very less number of lines will be written in the application software. For example of the system software, it is operating system and utility programs. Example of the application software, Excel, Word, PowerPoint, and all those things. Excel, Word, PowerPoint, and some mobile application, desktop application. Example of the system software is operating system, utility programs, debugger, linker, loader, assembler, and compilers. Thank you. In this lecture video, we'll finish up till the comparison between the system software and application software. In the next lecture, we'll discuss the different types of computers. Thank you.